Hello everyone, I'm going to make another resin painting on a MDF board, the same size as my previous video. It's 33 centimeters and I prime it as I always do with two layers of gesso and two layers of acrylic paint. And for this painting I painted the MDF board red, because I want to let that color shine through in the lacing or the cells, if I get that. And I already started with a thin layer of clear resin. And I'm spreading it around with my silicone spatula. And I'm using the same colors, except for the sassy red of Lares. I changed that in the deep ocean green of Lares, because I already have the red color of my MDF board, so that's why I changed it. And also the deep ocean green is a very nice color. It's transparent, but I like it. All the colors I'm using are listed in the beginning of this video and also in the description box. And if you want to see which colors I'm using, then you go check out the description box, and I also have the links. So I'm starting with a deep ocean green. It looks black at the moment, but I'm hoping if I'm placing the other colors next to it, that the beautiful color comes through. Next to it, the green apple of Color Art. I also used this color in my previous videos, very sparkly, very nice, bright and vibrant color. And next to it the stunco black, because I want to create some lacing or cells, and this pigment is very good to get those effects. On top of my deep ocean green, I'm pouring some golden diamonds of Color Art. Very sparkly. And also a little bit of white, the angel white of Lares, next to the green apple for the contrast. And now I'm heating it, not too much, only a little bit, and then I'm going to swipe again. And I'm going to swipe from the outside to the inside. So I'm dragging the colors over each other into the clear. And again I'm using the Yupo paper. I like that it's a little bit thicker. And the colors go very well together. I like it. A little bit of heat again, and then we will wait and see what kind of effects I'm getting. Now to the other side. First the red plum of Color Art. Very deep color, red color, very nice, sparkly, and I like sparkle. Next with the cool mint of Lares. And I also noticed that the effects will come later. You need to wait a little bit and then the effects will come. The cells or the lacing. It takes a little bit of time. Again the golden diamond of Color Art on the edge. And also some blinged gold. And then on top of the cool mint, or next to it, a little bit on top, a little bit next to it. And then I'm going to swipe again. Again from the outside to the inside. Yeah, and the effects already started in the green. Getting some nice lacing there. And again, I'm using the stone coat, art coat. For these kinds of paintings, I like the art coat a lot. And I also experienced that if you use the stone coat pigments, they do best in their resin also. And you have the best chance to get the effects you want. Now I'm working on the sides, on the edge. But I don't want to cover the whole MDF board. I want the red color to shine through in some places. I like that because that way you can create a lot of depth in it by only using one layer of resin. And after this this painting, I'm going to make one painting more with the Christmas colors, and then I'm going to start on a freeform geode again with some new material for the barriers. Yeah, and I'm getting more effects in the green. Little bit of heat again, not too much, because otherwise your effects will all be gone during drying. Now I'm tilting it a little bit to see if I can get more effects. Not too much, because I like the design I'm having at the moment. So very slowly I'm tilting my MDF board. There you can see very well the effects I have in the green. Also in this video, with the leftover resin, I'm going to make some coasters again. And by tilting very slowly, you let the paint move, or the resin move a little bit, and in that way you can also create some cells or lacing. You can already see it in the red part, the red plum part. I'm also again adding some mica flakes, but this time the copper color, and I also mix some holographic red glitter in it and some gold. I like sparkle, and especially with Christmas. So again, a line of mica flakes. And if they flow, I don't mind, not too much of course, but a little bit to the sides, I like that. Yeah, with my steering stick, I push the mica flakes to the place I want. The torch for the air bubbles. I'm almost done with this painting and then I'm going to start on the coasters. Only a blinged gold line on the edge because I want a sparkly edge. So I'm making a line with the blinged gold. So, almost done. And then I will let it dry. At the end of this video, also a close-up, then you can see if it changed or not. One more time the torch, and then I'm going to start on the coasters. So I'm going to start, and I'm using ceramic tiles of 10 by 10 centimeters. I taped the back, and I'm pouring my leftover resin on top of the tiles, and then we will see what I get. So I don't have a plan in my head, I just pick the colors and I'm pouring it on top of the tiles. So this is the red plum of color art, very nice color. Then the deep ocean green of Lures. You can see that it's transparent. Also the green apple of color art. And a little bit of stone cold black. Maybe I can get some nice effects with that. Also the cool mint of Lures. Very nice color is that. And also some golden diamond. And you can see I just pour it on and then I'm surprised what I get. So some heat on it. And then I try to blow the colors over each other. Working on the sides, if they are all covered with the resin. And this time I'm doing it with my fingers, a little bit easier that way. And I buy these tiles in a DIY store, so they are very cheap. I'm helping it a little bit over the edge. Now they are all covered. And I'm also adding some blinged gold of color art. More sparkle in it. And they look a little bit busy. The torch for the air bubbles. So then I'm done with the coasters, and then we can go to the close-up. So this is how the coasters look after 24 hours of drying. They changed a little bit. I like them better this way. And they sparkle a lot. The colors are very bright and vibrant. They blended nicely into each other, the colors. There you can see the golden diamond on top of the red plum. Very nice. A little bit closer now. There you can see it sparkle. The green apple sparkles a lot. Also the blinged gold you can see in the red plum. Yeah, they are nice. And this is the painting after 24 hours of drying. I'm very pleased with this painting. A lot of great effects, very nice lacing, and it has a lot of depth because the color of my MDF board, the red color shining through the lacing. I like that. So you can also create some depth with only one layer of resin. And the colors fit very well together. I like the mica flakes and the holographic glitter line. Some really nice effects there in the red plum. And also the line on the edge of the blinged gold I like very much. It sparkles a lot. A little bit closer. There you can see hope, the depth that I've created. There you can see the green apple, and also there some nice lacing where the red color is shining through. And the deep ocean green of Lares gives a nice contrast to next to the green apple. I like it. There are also some very nice lacing. The mica flakes up close. Sparkles a lot. Yeah, I'm very pleased with both paintings, Christmas paintings. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video. If you have tips, comments, questions, place them under the video or send me an email. My email address is in the description box. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram Also, those two links are in the description box. Also, where I buy my materials, you can find in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!